हे किड्स, हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू आवर कंप्यूटर क्लास। किड्स, वी आर स्टडिंग आवर चैप्टर नंबर 8, प्रोग्रामिंग इन स्क्रैच। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक विच इज मेकिंग अ वेरिएबल। दिस टॉपिक इज गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 72 इन योर कंप्यूटर टेक्स्ट बुक। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द स्टडी। First of all, what is variable? What is the meaning of variable? Let's see. A variable is a placeholder in Scratch memory that is used to store a changing value. It means variable is one type of container or box which can store any value, and variable can hold one value at a time. It means when we store new value, then old value will erase. Okay, so these values can be either numbers or strings. Strings means text. So we can store number as well as text inside the variable. Okay, now let's understand this easily. Now you can see on the screen one box. Guess this is the box, it variable. So when we put new value inside it, then you can see old value goes outside. Okay, so old value gone when we put new value inside variable. So this is the variable which stores data, either number or text, in Scratch. Now you can see on the screen here one picture is given. In the data block palette, variable is available. So you can see here in Scratch, data block is used to create variable. When we click on data block, it will display two block, make a variable and make a list. We want to make a variable, then we have to click on make a variable block. When we click on make a variable block, it will display one new variable box which name is variable name box. In this we have to type the variable name first, that whatever we want to keep, that we can, okay, any name we can give to the variable. Now below there two options, for all sprites and for these sprites only. From these two we have to choose one. When we choose for all sprites, then this variable will work for all the sprites on the stage. And when we choose for this sprite only, then this variable will work for the only one sprite that we have selected. And then after we have to click on OK. After that our variable is being made. So this way you can make a variable. So this is the explanation of it. Now let's see practically how can we make a variable by a project in Scratch. So kids, this is my computer screen. Let's start our Scratch program. So double clicking, click on this shortcut of Scratch 2. This is Scratch 2 offline editor window. Let's maximize this using this maximize button. Now first we have to delete this cat sprite. So right click on this cat sprite and select delete option. Now next we have to add a new sprite. So for this click on this new sprite option, first option, and here this is sprite library and we want Ruby sprite. So let's click on people category, click. Now find here Ruby sprite, go down, down, down. You can see this is our Ruby sprite. So click on it and click on OK button. You can see Ruby sprite is now available on the stage. Now next we have to make a variable. So where is variable? Yes, in the data block. So click on data block. Here make a variable block is available. So click on this. Now you can see one dialog box came which name is new variable. Here we have to type our variable name. We are going to give variable to name. Okay, so let's type name, name. So the variable name is name. Here two options, for all sprites or for this sprite only. We have only one sprite on the stage, so let's select for this sprite only. So click on this, it will selected. Now click on OK button, click. You can see our name variable is created, and here also our sprite name is Ruby, and this is the variable name, and this is the value. Here it is 0 because just now it is empty. That's why no value inside it. Okay. So let's start the script. This script is also given on page number 72 in your textbook. Okay. First we have to take a event. So click on event block and take when flag clicked event, because program will execute when we click on this green flag. Next we have to ask a question. For this we have to take ask block. So click on sensing block and take ask block and drag it to the script area. Now here we are going to ask name of this sprite. Okay, so this message is already done. What's your name? And wait, when we ask question, at that time one text box appear on the screen in which user can input the answer. Okay, so for that we have to take answer block. We have to put answer block inside the say block. So click on looks block and take say hello for 2 seconds block. Now inside this say block, in this white box, we have to add answer block. So again click on sensing block and take answer block from here and place inside the say block. Now let's change the timing. Here 2 is there, but click on this and change it to 5 seconds. Okay, because it will show for more time, that's why. Next we have to give this value to our variable. So how can we give the value in of answer in our variable? So for that we have to take set block of variable. So click on data and our variable has first block set block. Okay, so click on this and drag it to the script area. Now this is set name. Set means it, this block will store value inside this variable. Okay, so let's give here value and our value inside the answer block given by user. Okay, so let's put here answer block. So click on sensing block and take answer block from here and put inside these white blocks and release your mouse click. It will automatically paste it. Now our program is ready. Here first it asks question, what's your name? One text box will appear on the screen. In that text box we have to type name. Then after it, the name is stored in answer block. And then after, the answer block will give this value to the name variable, and this value is stored inside the variable. Let's execute the project by clicking on the green flag. Click. What's your name? This is text box. Type your answer here. Its name is Ruby. RUBBY. Ruby. Click on this tick mark. Click. You can see it will display Ruby. Say means display Ruby name displayed. It will for 5 seconds because we give 5 seconds only. Now you can see here. First of all here it is 0. But now the value is stored inside the variable. Which this value is? The name of this sprite, which is Ruby. Okay. Now this value is stored inside the variable. Now let's give another value. When we give new value to the variable, the old value will erase. So let's make some changes in the program. So click on this message and type new message. What is your roll number? ROLLNUMBER. What is your roll number? Now answer block will store the answer and then give to the name variable. Okay, let's click on this green flag. Click. What is your roll number? My roll number is 35. So here textbook type 35 from the keyboard and click on this tick mark. Click. Now this 35 number is stored inside the answer block, and answer block will give the value to name variable. Here you can see the value is changed now. First here is Ruby, but now it is 35 because we give new value to the variable. So old value is erased. So this way variable can store either number or string. Here number is 35. First we add string means text, that is Ruby. So this can store both either number or text, but only one value at a time. So this is all about making a variable in Scratch program. In next class, we will do further in this chapter. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.